A warm good morning to one and all children. So in the last class, we have learned a lot of things about industries which are based on minerals. So we have discussed about iron and steel industry as well as aluminium smelting. So these two industries are also playing very important role in the contribution of national economy towards the national economy there. So in which states the aluminium melting industries and the factories are been there, we have already discussed, as well as iron and steel industry. From that I have told one map question will come for you people, so you have to remember for that one. So in today's class we are going to learn about chemical industries. So these kind of industries are also present in our country. So yes, so the chemical industry is the fast growing and diversifying industry in our country. So it contributes nearly 3% to the GDP, and chemical industry in the Asia, it stands for third largest in the Asia and 12th place in the world. So it is third largest chemical industries which are present in our country stand in the third place in the entire Asia continent. So if you calculate for the world, it stand in the 12th place. So the rapid growth has been recorded in the both organic industries as well as in the unorganic industries. So organic chemicals include sulfuric acid, nitric acid, alkalines, soda ash, caustic soda are widely spreaded over the country. So inorganic chemicals are also been produced in our country for various for various usage. So based on that one, inorganic chemical industries have been there. They include sulfuric acid, nitric acid, etc. chemicals, and it will be produced in our country there. So organic chemicals included, the organic chemicals include petrochemical industries, which are used for manufacturing synthetic fiber, synthetic rubber, plastic, dye stuff, drugs, as well as pharmaceuticals. Organic chemical plants are located near the oil refineries as well as petrochemical plant, because it is very easily we can transport from one place to another place in our country. So the chemical industries are being divided into two parts. One is organic and second one is the inorganic chemical industries. So in the organic, varieties of chemicals are being produced, that for examples like sulfuric acid, nitric acid, alkaline, soda ash, caustic soda are widely spreaded in the entire country. So same thing, organic chemicals are also being produced in our country as well as manufactured in our country based on some raw materials, that is petrochemicals, which are used for manufacturing various kinds, that is synthetic fiber, synthetic rubber, plastic, drug, pharmaceutical. So organic plants are located near the oil refineries or wherever the petrochemical plants are been there. Plants means nothing but factories as well as industries which are located. So chemical industries has its own largest consumers in our country. So the basic chemicals undergo the process to the further produce other chemicals that are used for industrial application, agriculture, or directly for the consumer market for the usage. Okay, nitric acid, alkalis, ash, soda used to make the glass, soap, and detergent as well as the paper. Okay, so inorganic chemicals, sulfuric acid used in the manufacturing of fertilizers, synthetic fibers, plastic, paints, dye stuff, etc. are being used while using the sulfuric acid there. Okay, so same thing, organic chemicals are used to produce the glass, soap, detergents as well as the paper by using the various kinds of chemicals which are used in our country. So the chemical industries is its own largest consumer. Basic chemicals undergo the process of further further process to get the final product there. So further process will be there for other chemicals which are used in our country and other chemicals that are used for industrial application, agriculture, or directly to the consumer market. So some of the chemicals are being used for the industrial purpose only, and some chemicals are used in the agriculture, like pesticides, insecticides, fertilizers. These chemicals are being used in the agriculture. So for the direct consumers, caustic soda. Caustic soda is used to wash the clothes, etc. They will use. Some of the chemicals will be used for the consumer usage also. So directly they may go towards the consumers for the agricultural usage as well as for the industrial application. So this chemical industries plays a very important role in our country for the economic development. So nearly it contributes 3% of GDP and it stands third largest in the Asia and 12th place in the world. So the chemical industry is further divided into two parts. One is organic and second one is the inorganic. So moving further, next one is the fertilizer industry. So fertilizers, you all know category as well as for which usage the fertilizers are being used. Okay, so the fertilizer industry is centered around the production of nitrogenous fertilizers, phosphatic fertilizers, and ammonium phosphate, that is DAP. So the fertilizer industry are being combination of these chemicals which will produce the fertilizers. So the complex fertilizers which have the combination of nitrogen, phosphate as well as potash. So some of the complex fertilizers will be there, high graded fertilizers will be there. So their combination is nitrogen, phosphate as well as potash. So in India, India is the third largest producer of nitrogenous fertilizers in our country as well as in the world. So nearly there are 57 fertilizer unit, 29 units of urea, 9 producing ammonium sulfate. So how many fertilizers industries are there in our country are fertilizers. Main thing the fertilizers, 57 fertilizers units are been there. Among those 29 will produce the urea and 9 produce the ammonium sulfate there for the fertilizer. And 68 other small units are been there which produce the super phosphate in our country. So 10 fertilizer industries are under the control of public sector at Hazira in Gujarat under the control of Fertilizer Corporation of India. So under that one, the fertilizer industries, 10 fertilizer industry are under the control of government. So in the world, India produces, it is the third largest producer of fertilizers, that is nitrogenous fertilizer in our country. So in other state also the fertilizer industries have been there, which has been located in some states. So shall we move, what are the places, in which places the fertilizer industries are been there. So first one is Gujarat. I have told nearly 10 public, under the public sector, 10 fertilizer industries are been there under the Fertilizer Corporation of India. They will produce the fertilizers. Next one in Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Rajasthan, Bihar, Maharashtra, Assam, West Bengal, Goa, Delhi, Madhya Pradesh and Karnataka. So in these places we will see the fertilizers industries are been located in our country. So for a 3 marks, they can give a short note on, write a short note on chemical plus fertilizer industry. So you have to write some important aspects like how much percentage the GDP is there in the chemical and in which places the chemical industries are being located, the two types of industries, and same thing in the fertilizers also. So moving further, next one is the cement industry. Cement industries is also playing very important role in the economic development. Okay, cement for various usage, the cement industry is important. For what all means? For the construction of building house, If you are constructing a building, means cement is important. If you are constructing any kind of factories, bridges, roads, airports, dam, and for other commercial establishments, the cement play a very important role for these economic activities. Without cement, you can't build the house also in a very good condition in the towns and city area. Nowadays, with the cement only, they are building the houses. Even if you want to establish any kind of factories, the cement will also play a very important role there. So, this industry is categorized under the bulky and heavy, because whatever raw materials we are using in a bulk way, we are using in a heavy, in a weightful materials we are using to produce the cement. So, what all materials are needed to produce the cement are limestone, silica, aluminium and gypsum. So these are the raw materials used to produce the cement in our country. So these raw materials are very much heavy and very much bulky. Bulky means weight. So this industry will categorized under the heavy and bulky industries there. Okay, so cement is the essential for the construction of various usage. So it is an activity such as for the construction of houses, factories, buildings, any kind of bridges you are constructing, means the cement is playing very important role, as well as in the construction of roads. In your surrounding only, the cement roads are being constructing there. So cement is essential goods, as well as it is an essential product there. So I have told this industry is very bulky as well as heavy industry, because heavy materials we are using to produce the cement. Coal and electric power are needed apart of all railway transportation. So cement industries are located in most of the cement industries are located in the Gujarat, because it is during that time it was a suitable condition to export the cement to the other Gulf of countries which are situated in the other part of the world. And it is also situated in the port side area. So in the Gujarat, most of the industries were been concentrated there. Okay. So among those, the first cement industry was set up in Chennai in 1904. Afterwards, it was been spreaded in the entire India. After the independence, the industry was been expanded due to the new technologies were been adopted in the producing of cement. So decontrol of price and distribution since 1989 and other policies reform the lead of cement industry in the make a rapid expanded, that is a rapid production in the cement industry. So after 1989, certain facilities, certain policies were been implemented to improve the cement industries, like the production should be very quick within a period this much of bulk. The cement industry should be grown in our country. So in this way, the cement industries took a rapid under the policies and under the facilities which are given by our country after independence. So the first cement industry was set up in Chennai in the year 1904. Now at present, how many cement industries are there? Means nearly 128 large plants, large cement industries are been there, and 332 mini cement plants are there in our country. So the improvement in the quality has founded the produce readily available in the market. So yeah, when this kind of due to the improvised technology as well as the policies which were implemented for the cement industry's growth, so it increased the quality of the cement also. So as a result, this cement industries are being exported to the East Asia, Middle East Asia, Africa and South Asia, and it is having a large demand within our country only. So cement industries is growing day to day very rapidly and very quickly there. So our cement are been exported to the other international market, that is in East Asia, Middle East as well as Africa and South Asia, apart from a large demand within a country there. So even though still efforts are being made to generate adequate domestic demand and the supply in order to sustain this industry. So even till today also, even though we are giving a quality cement towards the global market also, still the efforts are being made by the industrialist people to improvise their cement industry in our country as well as to sustain this industry there. So next one, moving further, automobile industry. So you all know automobile is playing very important role in the transport and communication. So nowadays quick transportation are being introduced for the people to carry the goods and services as well as to carry the passengers very quickly from one place to another place. So automobile will provide a quick transportation to the goods and services as well as for the passengers. So there are three wheelers and multi-utility vehicles are being produced as well as manufactured in our country at the various places. So after the liberalization, a lot of changes took place in this country. A lot of new technologies were being introduced for the in the production as well as in the manufacturing of automobile industry in our country. So direct foreign investment brought a new technology and a support for the global industries to compete in the global market and global developments also. So in this way, direct foreign investment helped very lot to improvise the automobile industry in our country. So at present, 15 manufacturing passengers carriers are been there and multi-utility vehicles are been produced and 9 commercial vehicles are been produced and 14 two and three wheelers vehicles are been produced in our country. So automobile industries are been categorized under the various usage: three wheelers, two wheelers, multi-utility vehicles are been produced, 9 commercial vehicles are been produced in our country. So at present, how many? 15 manufacturers of passenger cars and multi-utility vehicles are been produced. 9 commercial vehicles industries are been there with what they are producing, and 14 automobile industry will produce the 2 and 3 wheeler vehicles for the transportation from one place to another place. So due to the liberalization, a lot of changes took place in the automobile industry. New technology, new rapid growth, as well as a healthy growth, we can see the demand of vehicles was been increased after the liberalization. So most of the people, they started buying the vehicles for their transportation. So the demand was been increased due to their demand, quality, quantity, yearly it was been increasing. So after the liberalization, lot of changes took place. The demand was been increased for the automobile industry. A healthy competition was been atmosphere was been created in our country to compete in the global market. So at present, 15 manufacturer industry, that is automobile industry, produce the passenger cars and multi-utility vehicles. 9 industries, they will produce the commercial vehicles, and 14 industries they are producing as well as they are manufacturing 2 and 3 wheeler vehicles for the transportation. So the main in which area the industries are being located means in Delhi, Goregaon, Mumbai, Pune, Chennai, Kolkata, Lucknow, Indore, Hyderabad, Jamshedpur, as well as in the Bangalore. So in all these places, our industry, the automobile industries are being located, and it produced and it will produce as well as manufacture the vehicles according to the demand and supply. So this automobile industry is also playing very important role in the contribution of GDP in our country. So next kind of category is information technology and electronic industries. So electronic industry covers a wide range of the products. Lot of products are being produced in the information technology as well as in the electronic industries. In what way? The transistor sets to a television, telephone, cellular telecom, pagers, telephone exchange, radar, computers, and many other equipments required by the telecommunication industry. So these are all products are being produced in our country, from a small wire to a big computer, whatever final product, computer or a telephone or a mobile phone you are seeing. So that is the, from a small thing to a big thing, the information technology as well as telecommunication is playing very important role at the present technology. So among those, Bangalore city in our Karnataka is emerged as well as it come out as electronic capital of our country. Bangalore has emerged as electronic capital of India, and other important centers of information technology and electronic industries are located in Mumbai, Delhi, Hyderabad, Pune, Chennai, Kolkata, Lucknow, and Coimbatore. So in this important centers, we will see the information technology as well as electronic industries are being produced variety of products for the usage of the people according to the demand. So by 2010 and 11, Software Technology Park of India come across nearly 46 locations in our country. In 46 places, we will see the Software Technology Park are being located. So the major industries are located in Bangalore, Noida, Mumbai, Chennai, Hyderabad, and Pune. So this industry has been a major foreign exchange earner in the last 2 to 3 years because of its fast growing business processing outscoring sector. So in the recent 2 to 3 years, due to the utilization of technology, it has been the foreign exchange has been increased in our country due to the information technology as well as electronic industries. So the continuing growth in the hardware and the software is the key success of IT industry in our country. So how the hardwares and the software demand has been increasing nowadays. So it is the key success of information technology industry in our country. It is the key success nowadays. This IT industries are playing very important role in the contribution, in the contributing the in the national income as well as in the GDP, because most of the people, they are using the high tech technology, information technology for their communication basis. If you take a mobile phone, if you take a laptop, as well as any kind of a software, okay, within a minute you will get the services very quickly there, as well as it is one of the important major aspect of foreign exchange. Most of the foreign people, they will do the earning in this kind of industries only. So from this information and technology and electronic industry, one map will become for you people. So about the software park. Okay, you can see a laser point. So in a star mark, they have been located how many kinds of software technology park are there in our country. So you have to remember some places like Kolkata, Bangalore, Mysore, Tiruvananthapuram, Chennai, even Coimbatore, Mumbai, Pune, Gandhinagar, Noida, Guwahati, Kolkata, Pune, Srinagar. These are the some of the important software technology park which is located in our country. So in the next class, I am going to discuss about industrial pollution as well as environmental degradation. Even though this kind of development we will see in the industries, in the manufacturing industries, even that leads towards the environmental disturbances. So in what way we are going to, as well as I am going to discuss in the next session. I hope today's class you have understood about other industries which are located in our country. So if you are having any kind of doubt, just pin your question in the group so that I will try my level best to sort out your problem. So signing out, have a great day. Bye everyone.